Hey guys, so excited we have Elias Harger here. Tune in.
You're tuned in to AfterBuzz TV, the ESPN of TV talk. Now, let the buzz begin.
I made no promises. I can't do golden rings, but I'll give you everything.
I had to wait till I came to that point. This is such a fun song. Elias's favorite choice to dance into.
He loves when she says, tonight.
That's his favorite part.
It's so weird.
Thank you all for joining us to a Fuller House After Show. We're so excited because we've been wanting to talk to Elias. And
literally,
he's finally
like
here.
Years.
I know. We're so excited. I'm your host, Annika Michelle. You can find me at Annika Michelle 1.
Boom. It's your boy, DJ Jesse J. And y'all can find me everywhere, DJ Jesse J.
Yeah.
It's Elias Harger. You can find me at Elias Harger.
There you go. And there's the handles on the bottom so you guys can look at that and follow as well.
Yeah.
Welcome. We're so happy you're here.
It's really fun to be here.
I know. Oh, my God. We've been wanting
you to
come on.
We've been wanting you to come on, honestly.
Cool.
And your character, one of our favorites.
Seriously, yay. You crack us up.
You're hilarious.
You're hilarious.
That's, and you're hilarious in person.
In person, too.
Thank
so
you.
I feel like it comes from that as well.
Yep.
Totally.
Big thing coming from you, sir.
Yeah.
Good thing to know I'm funny on off show, too.
Yeah, you totally are. And I've interviewed a lot of basically everyone in the Full House and Fuller House cast. So you like kind of, I think the only one I have left now is Kimmy, and that's it. That will close the entire cast of Full and Fuller House that I've interviewed. You've come in, so now I just need Andrea Barber, that's it.
Yeah, Andrea's really fun.
Yeah, I've met her. I've just not interviewed her. But that's it. One more to go.
We're almost there. We're almost there.
We got this.
Yeah.
But we're so excited. And, like, I know obviously you're younger and you weren't, you know, around when Full House was airing on TV.
Yeah.
But did you have to watch that? Like, what was your audition like? Did you watch Full House to prepare at all?
I didn't actually have to watch it to prepare because I'd been watching it even before I even got the original audition.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, who hasn't?
Right.
It's everywhere.
Yeah.
It is everywhere. It is.
Yeah. My first audition, like any typical audition back when I lived in Colorado, usually if it was like a real serious audition, it probably came from somewhere else, so I had to tape it, not go in person.
Yeah.
So, of course, like, I learned the lines like usual, did the sides. The same day, I got my call back.
Oh, wow. That's huge.
And they gave some very specific instructions, and my agent really wanted me to get those specific instructions right.
Yeah.
Let's just say it took a while. took a while to get the perfect tape.
Okay.
And,
but it was worth
but you
it.
Did
it. It was worth
it. You got it. You got the same day. That's everything.
Yeah. That was only my audition, though, because then I had to wait a month. We had completely forgotten about it by the time they asked to fly me here to test me for the role.
That's huge.
And,
had you ever been to L.A. before?
No. No, not that I remember, at least. But, yeah, for the testing, I had to learn new lines.
Okay.
Because they changed the scene that they were having us do. So I go in, test with the Sony and the original Jackson Cannon.
Yes.
The original guy they had cast for Jackson.
Right.
And
he told us that story when he came on.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And after that, they decided that they were just going to go back to the original script, which I hadn't read for a month.
Oh, no.
Good thing I had an amazing memory.
Yeah.
Because it only took us, like, one read for me to re-memorize it.
Yeah. That's huge.
Wow.
I don't know if many adults can even do that.
No, you're putting me to shame.
Like, honestly.
They make me read this. I've read this for, like, years, and I'm struggling. So you get to L.A. So when did you actually get to step on set and kind of see the whole Full House, the actual house, and what was that like?
Oh, that was after. Like, I don't remember how long after, but first I had to get the role.
Right.
I got the same day as the testing.
Oh, my gosh.
And, after that, we flew home. A few weeks, maybe a month later, we flew back.
Now, did you do a table read with everybody?
It was 2 days later. Then, yeah, we came in, did one big table read with everybody. Everybody introduced each other, and that's when I read, well, technically I'd read the first script on the plane there, because we were, I think I had to read two scripts, if I remember correctly.
Okay.
And, yeah, I had to learn them on the plane ride there.
Yeah.
Which is only 2 hours.
Right.
2 days to drive here, 2 hours to fly here. Yeah. So, yeah, it shortens it a little bit.
Yeah, just a little.
But, after that, I don't really remember how long after, we went on set for the first time and started filming. The regular week is first day learning blocking and finally memorizing for the last time the script. Then you kind of, they change the script, you have to relearn the script and remember the blocking. Sometimes they change it a little. Third day is pre-tape day, where they bring in the cameras. It's not live taping day.
Yeah.
Because, like, during live taping day, there's a lot of noise and commotion, and you have a certain time limit that you have to get it done on, because there's a live audience.
Right.
And you don't want them there until 2 in the morning. But, yeah, so we basically film the scenes just in case something goes wrong on live taping day.
Right.
Then the last day, which is usually Friday, but sometimes Thursday, we do the live taping. And, yeah, that's really exciting because you have the DJ and the live audience and all the cameras. And it's just, it's really fun because if we have something important coming or, like, something really, like, big in the show, like, for instance, when Jackson was trying to help Ramona escape from school in one of the first seasons. We were not allowed to do that until pre-tape day, and I wasn't allowed to see it until live taping day.
Wow.
Well, so they like to surprise you guys, too?
They can't. Well, I mean, I had to do school.
Because you're juggling that, too. Yeah,
like, you kind of have to go back and forth from school because, of course, you legally have to get school in.
Of course.
And, yeah. So, during live taping day, there's usually school in the morning because the live taping is until much later in the night when schooling's already over. So, yeah, I didn't really get to see that till then. And also, they can only do it once because you have no clue how long it takes to clean that sort of stuff.
Oh, I'm sure. I'm sure it's like it takes
forever.
Multiple people.
Okay. Mm-hmm. They're like, all right, we got one shot.
Yeah,
one
we
shot
better
only.
Get this right now.
What's one of your favorite moments from set? Funniest moments from set?
What's happened? Like one of the funniest scenes.
Something funny behind the scenes that like
a story you can share.
I'm not sure if this is, well, it's funny for some of the other people, not necessarily Michael. When it was Michael's birthday, one of the seasons, he got this little robot drone type thing, and he was driving it down the hallway with where all our dressing rooms are, and Bob turns the corner and steps right on it without even knowing it.
And he's a tall man,
Like the robot just goes.
Just falls over. So did he end up getting a new one?
Yeah, I think Bob got him a new one. I didn't track it, of course. I didn't pay attention whether or not that actually happened. But Bob said he was going to get a new one, and I believe that.
I believe he probably did, too. That's so crazy. Yeah. Obviously, your character is hilarious, and we know you're hilarious in real life. But how would you say you're similar and different than your character?
Uni. Biggest similarity between me and Max.
Uni?
Uni. You know the unicorn? Max's
favorite toy in the
show?
I was like, uni.
She's actually my favorite toy first.
Okay.
I asked everybody if she could come on to the show, and
Okay.
Oh, really? So you brought that in.
Mm-hmm. It's like a personal, and that's actually yours that we see on TV.
Yeah, the clever way of getting rid of that was Frank and Uni.
Oh.
Still not happy about that.
Dum, dum, dum.
So how would you say you're different than your character then?
I'm not very tidy.
Oh, okay.
Like, this is
not what you would usually
wear.
Okay.
Well, I mean, I guess it kind of is. Just take this off and
your shirt.
T-shirt and jeans.
Yeah.
But when I'm around, like, the house, definitely on, like, school breaks, I don't even get dressed in the morning. I just wear my pajamas until I have to leave the
house. As you should, dude. As you should. Relax. So much
Mom's over here like,
don't so support much easier.
Bad behavior.
Yeah.
So much easier.
And it's so comfortable.
I know.
If they didn't want us to wear it, they wouldn't make it comfortable is all I'm saying.
Look, exactly. Thanksgiving, I made everyone wear onesies.
Yes. Onesie party.
I had never worn a onesie before.
That's hilarious.
2 days in a row.
Yeah.
I was cool. That lazy.
I love it. I love it. That's so good.
Okay. So juggling school and filming. What is that kind of like? Like, do you have to do online classes? Do you actually get to go to a campus?
We don't go to a campus. So season one, we had trailers that were our dressing rooms because it wasn't a very big set. It was a little smaller.
Okay.
So outside, we had a bunch of trailers, and there were big trailers. Smaller for the kids because they need less room. But then there's my little school room, which was much smaller than all the other trailers, slightly smaller than this room, actually.
Really?
Wow.
Yeah.
But you were the only one in there,
really
right?
Intense. I was
the
one-on-one only one teaching.
Yeah, the teenagers, they got their own classroom on set with their own teacher.
Okay.
But since one, I was learning a different language.
Oh.
And two, I was much younger.
Yeah.
I got my own teacher and my own schoolroom.
Okay. So what's the language?
Spanish.
Nice.
Very cool.
I haven't been doing Spanish a lot lately because now I'm homeschooled by my mom.
Nice.
So
So does she teach you on set then? The hours you're supposed to be at school?
No.
Okay.
Legally, she can't.
Oh, she can't.
She can't.
Oh, I didn't know that.
I mean, homeschooling, offset, yeah. But they have to hire a teacher.
A teacher on set. No, that makes complete sense.
They're very relieved that I'm no longer in a Spanish school, though, because now they don't have to hire a Spanish-speaking teacher. They can just hire a teacher.
Totally.
But, we still do our best to kind of substitute not school Spanish for school.
Yeah.
Spanish, but to answer your question, it's very difficult because you have to do 4 hours of schooling a day.
Okay.
But you also have to get your filming done. So when you're on set, you film. As soon as you have a break, unless it's lunch, you have to go to school.
Yeah.
But usually, since you have to do your schooling, you only get a few minutes of it, though. Because when you go back on set, it's like... So when you go offset, they still have to film. So and filming is usually very fast when it's not a taping night, one of the two. So, like, you go on set, do your scene, get offset, do school. A few minutes later, have to go back on set.
Yeah. Wow. Okay. And they just
I'm surprised you didn't start speaking Spanish randomly. Just like caught up in the classroom on set, huh?
Yeah.
Who is one of your favorite people to shoot scenes with?
Well, I like shooting scenes with everybody, but one of my favorite people to shoot a scene with is Juan Pablo. I love the dynamic between Fernando and Max.
Yeah.
It's just a ton of fun, and I know the fans love it, too.
Totally. Mm-hmm. He's a fun one, too. Do you practice your Spanish with him ever?
Yeah, we've actually gotten an argument, like, not serious arguments, just, like, joking around on offset. Arguments, like, on set, but not when we're filming.
Yeah.
Arguments were, like, I'll say stuff like, go to the corner, you've been a bad boy. And he'll be like, no, I haven't. You can be
That's so good. I want to see more of that. So if any of the writers are watching, let's put that in.
Do more Fernando Max scenes.
Yeah, you guys are definitely, like, I feel like very similar characters in a way.
Aside from the fact that we're arch enemies.
I mean, like, character-wise, I just feel like you guys are both, like, energetic. Mm-hmm. You guys are both funny, like, character-wise, not...
pretty tidy, I guess.
Yeah, you know?
He's definitely controlling, Fernando and Max.
Yeah, both. Yeah. Both. See, like, that's what I'm saying. You guys have similarities that I would love to see.
I've never really thought about that before.
I would love to see that. Characters. Yeah, you totally are.
Do you ever play any pranks on set?
No, but I definitely get pranks played on me.
Oh, really?
What was the funniest prank ever played on you? Or that shocked you the most?
Well, Michael's been doing magic lately.
Okay.
And on set.
Is he good at it?
Yeah, much better than me, I can say. He's been teaching me a few tricks, but...
Nice.
Yeah. I guess the biggest prank I can remember at the moment is I stepped outside of my dressing room.
Mm-hmm.
And he's pretty good at throwing cards. Oh. And the next thing I know,
oh my gosh,
a card is whooshing through the air right by me. And I turn around, there's no one there. So I turn around, start walking again, and another one whooshes by me. And I turn around, and Michael's standing there, and he's just throwing all these cards at me.
Oh my gosh, that's crazy. That's a skill right there.
It's like
I can't
Gambit
get
from X-Men.
A card to go anywhere.
Really? I can throw cards.
Oh, can you?
I can throw cards, but I'm horrible at aim.
Oh, horrible. I can't even throw
I'm
them.
I'm the same way with the baseball.
Same.
God, just throw
I'm bad at baseball, too.
Oh,
I'm bad at old sports games.
Really?
Aside from swimming.
Well, that's good.
That's a fun
because
one.
Because you're an amazing actor. So it's like, who needs to play sports?
You know.
Thanks.
You know.
But what do you like to do when you're not shooting? I mean, you've got school on shoot, you know, when you're shooting.
Fun-wise.
Well, fun-wise. Like, we're talking about fun.
Like what are your hobbies?
Not school.
And not sports.
obviously. That's not.
Obviously. Not
do you play any instruments?
Yeah, I play the piano.
I had a feeling. I was like, this kid's too smart.
We have this really, 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 really cool piano in our house.
Mm-hmm.
And right above it, we have this really beautiful, like, it looks like amber glass. I'm pretty sure it's not, but it looks like it.
Okay.
And, like, little lamp. It's like brass plated amber looking glass and this light above it, like on the piano.
Mm-hmm.
It's a beautiful, beautiful lamp. And then there's the piano. And actually, I started teaching myself a Christmas song just a few days ago.
You read music too, or you just do it by ear?
I do both. Like, I read it and then memorize it.
Okay.
Like a script.
Yeah. That's amazing.
What was easier for you, memorizing script or music?
Definitely memorizing a script.
Really?
Because months ago, I was horrible at reading music.
Wow.
They're not letters.
I know.
They all
they're
are
dots.
The same exact shape.
I get
they're
it.
They're just on different places.
True.
I get it.
I've completely memorized the like the treble clef, but I don't know the bass clef.
Me and you are on the same. I can read the treble clef day and night. I can play with my right hand, the left hand. I'm like, what is... Hold up. I'm just going to play with my right hand. Do we need the left hand involved right now?
I can only do the same. Dunk.
Yeah. That's warm up.
Yeah.
And that's as far as I go. So you're whooping me. Who is your favorite guest star?
So far?
On the show so far.
Huh. Well, one from season 4, actually.
Okay. Oh.
I can't exactly tell you who.
Okay.
But he is a very important person in my life.
Oh. So we got to make sure we stay tuned.
And it's premiering December 14th, correct?
Mm-hmm.
I'm so excited.
I can't wait to.
I can't wait. We got set that Netflix is like sending reminders already. I think as I watched the full season. They're like, just to let you know, Annika.
Coming back.
It's coming back.
If you could shoot with anybody.
Actor or musician.
Like you can pull not the guest star that's coming. Let's say this is a dream person. Who would you want to
It doesn't they don't have to come to Fuller House. Or they could come through Fuller House.
Yeah, I want to see who's coming to the house that you could pick if the director's like anyone you want in the world.
Probably first and foremost my sister.
Aww, that's so cute.
Yeah.
Is she an actress too?
Yeah.
She's younger than you.
Yeah, she's actually coming out in a show soon.
Oh, really? That's awesome.
Well, just runs in the family.
Yeah, talent is just oozing out over here. I love it.
Okay. Wait, and you were talking about this other show that you worked on, Creep.
He watched.
Oh, I watched it.
Creeped out.
Oh, you watched it? I thought he was on it. I was like...
No.
No.
That'd be weird if he was on it and didn't know who was behind the mask.
Well,
that'd be creepy.
That's the theme of the TV show he was saying.
That is a theme of the
so
TV
show.
So
you like watching scary stuff.
Yeah. My mom's definitely favorite? Inflicted that in all three of us.
Oh, wow.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh.
She loves scary movies. And my sister definitely loves scary movies. And my brother doesn't like scary movies. And I like scary movies.
What's your favorite scary movie?
What's your favorite? If you could pick one.
Not Creeped Out because it's not that scary. It's actually just really cool.
Okay.
It's just really cool. But out of the horror films I've watched, it would probably be Trick or Treat. Yeah.
Ooh.
Wow.
Have you seen that?
My mother would never.
Yeah.
It's really,
that is a good one.
It's, yeah, it's really, really, really good.
What's your dream role?
My dream role is to be the main character in an action-adventure feature film.
Like Marvel, like we're talking about.
Do you
like
want superpowers or just like...
I would either like to be very good with a bow and arrow or have superpowers.
Why not both?
True.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A bow and arrow, that's an interesting
choice. That's an interesting choice. I was like...
I've been watching Arrow lately.
Okay,
that makes a lot more
sense. And I just read the Hunger Games trilogy and then watched it. So yeah, I'm kind of interested in a bow and arrow at the moment.
That's all awesome. Right.
That's very cool. Maybe have you ever shot one?
Yes, actually, I'm taking archery classes every Wednesday.
Oh, wow.
Of course you are.
So is that in the list of things you like to do when you're not shooting? So archery classes?
Yeah. I like to swim, play piano. I like to do archery, gymnastics, and I've lost track.
You keep busy. I love this.
On the show.
Oh, I play on my iPad and watch television, of course.
Relaxing time, of course.
And I like to play on my bike, and I just got a yo-yo. Not very good at it, but...
Can you do the Eiffel Tower on the yo-yo? I learned how to do that because it's like supposed to be the easiest trick.
No, I haven't learned how to do that yet.
Okay. If I can do it, you can do it,
I promise you. I'm trying to learn that, believe it or not, there's actually a bow and arrow trick.
Oh! Really?
You basically get a good sleeper, form your hand like that, and pull the string through, aim, and let go, and then it comes back to your hand.
Oh!
There's also eating pizza.
Where and you pull it. Oh!
Do people tell you have an old soul? Have you ever heard that? No.
Yeah,
but you do.
I mean, of course. I, not in that exact wording, but yeah.
Yeah, it's a good thing.
I like very old things.
You do, because the fact that you were watching Full House before it came, you even knew about it. That's amazing.
Yeah. He has a point, though. It is always on TV.
Yeah. I don't ever catch it.
What, do you have cable? It's always on. I feel like it's always on some channel.
I'm a DVR king.
Okay. It's always on some channel. I'm not complaining. I love it. And you better believe I sit and watch every time it's on.
Well, what do you... So you say you are on your iPod watching TV. So what shows are you binge watching right now?
Creeped Out.
Creeped Out. But you finished that one. What's next on the list?
SNL and The Arrow.
Ooh. Okay.
I love SNL. Super funny.
It is really... Maybe you'll be on it one day.
You
I could see that.
Definitely should be on it.
Yeah.
I could see... Totally see that. Right?
Yeah.
We tune in like a few years and there he is.
I'll send John right now.
Yes. He'd be great.
I think he can keep up. No, I can't. Boy, if I could do that, I wouldn't be here right now, right?
He'd be all right at SNL himself.
I'd be filming it right now.
Yeah. And I'm sure, like, you know, working with the cast, they all give you advice. Mm-hmm. What's the best advice you've received from the cast? It could be from anyone in there. You could say who said it and, like, what they said. Huh. It could be, like, they said, I don't know, tie your shoes so you don't fall. That's not good advice, but you know.
Yeah. That's my mom, actually. She's the one who does that. But, yeah, someone on set.
Like, any of the actors or anything, like, some wisdom. Because they used to all be kids, don't forget, in Full House, you know. Yeah.
Has Bob said anything?
Not that I can remember.
Okay.
He's definitely asked me to play pranks on people, though.
Oh,
I think
so
you should take him
up
on it. I could see this going
down. I think it's time you flip the script.
I think so, too.
Oh, I would love that. I would love that so much.
I think you can get some of them on your side and prank Michael and Sony.
Especially if you have a good eye and you're good with the bow and arrow.
Oh.
You ever take one of those, you take the paper and you fold it with a little elastic band, you pop it, you can get Michael back.
That'd be so much fun.
All right, well, what advice would you give to someone who wants to get into the field of acting? Like, what advice have you learned that you would give to someone who wants to go out for an audition, or maybe they have an audition coming up? What would some advice that you would give them?
Well, for one, be yourself, definitely. Don't... One thing that people have advised me to do, and I would happily advise others to do, is to not try to be someone else. You are acting to be a character, but don't try to make that character someone else who you aren't, because then it doesn't seem natural.
Right.
Do stuff that are natural. And the other thing... would probably be to stay in your community first. Like, if you're just getting started, don't, like, for instance, with a bow and arrow, if you're trying to start with a bow and arrow, don't go shooting a 30-mile target on your first day.
Right. Baby steps.
But, like, start in your community. It's going to be easy. Like, just try to be in, like...
Like a school play.
Yeah, school plays, student films, local theaters, commercials, like anything you can do in your own community.
Yeah.
And then with memorizing, do you have any tricks to memorize?
Jesse's
scripts?
Like, I need this script. I need this myself. Hold my on, pen? What you doing?
Yeah. here's a funny story. Actually, when I was doing the testing for Fuller House, they came out and asked me how I memorized that script I hadn't done in a month, in less yeah. than a minute. And I was playing on my iPad doing, I forget, I think it was Minecraft.
Yeah.
Before Roblox Good was game. Invented. And I was just sitting there and they asked me, how did you do that? And I just go, it's a gift.
And then, bam, he got the part, guys. That's how he did it.
Amen. Yeah, I really don't know how I do it. It just...
Do you have a photographic memory? I have that. Where you can, like, see the paper and it comes to your head and you just read it off. Is it photographic? Like, you see it, like, as a picture?
He's like, no.
I don't know. I just, like...
I'm just that
When I say something, I remember how I said it, what I said, and where I said it.
Okay.
I don't know what kind of memory that is.
Yeah. Whatever it is, it's working. Whatever kind of memory.
It's a memory.
Okay. Yeah. That's awesome.
All right, so season 4.
Can you give us, like, any teasers?
Any teaser.
Anything. We know somebody special is going to be in it.
Yeah. Aside from that, you all know Kimmy is pregnant with Stephanie.
Pregnant. We left
Kimmy's
that.
Baby.
Yep.
Yeah, that's a big storyline this season.
I want to see that baby.
Yeah.
Or maybe it's twins.
Oh, then it's
Oh, my gosh.
It should be changed the title to Fullest House.
Full
House.
Yeah, I mean, like, thinking there's Full House, Fuller House. It's going to come back
for
the three girls, the grandmas, and me,
yeah.
Michael,
yeah,
and...
y'all's kids.
Yeah, yeah. Me, Michael and Sony, we're the grown-ups, and then we have Fullest House, where there are even more people, and then there's great-grandpa, and...
Yeah.
Well, at least you're thinking ahead, because this is going to keep you booked for
forever. Yeah. And it seems like everyone, from what I can tell and what I can see from everyone seems to get along really well, and... Mm. Everyone seems to really care about each other, which I know is rare to find. So you guys are lucky in that sense for
like
sure.
Like a real family.
Yeah, it really is a real family on set and off set.
That's awesome. That's
now, how
so
often
cute.
Are you guys filming?
You're
you
done now.
You've already shot four seasons.
Now.
So
yeah,
is it like once a year, twice a year?
It's usually every year.
Okay.
Like every like, so if it's 13 episodes, we usually film for about 4 months.
Okay.
And then the rest of the year's off, and then we redo. So yeah. We kind of just film part of the year and then have off the rest of the year.
Okay.
But when it's 18 episodes, it's 6 months.
Okay.
Because each episode, remember, is a week.
Right.
So, yeah.
And then you have to have weeks off in between, too, so.
Yeah, then we have the hiatus weeks. Like, every three episodes, we have a hiatus week.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Make sure you guys set your playlist on your DVR to on Netflix.
Netflix DVR. I love
it's
it.
All the same.
December 14th.
Boom. Yeah.
I can't wait.
Now, where can everyone follow you and keep
at Elias Harger
on Instagram, on
and
all the...
all of them, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook.
There it is, at Elias Harger.
Amen. Y'all can hit me up everywhere at DJ Jesse J.
And you guys can find me at Annika Michelle 1. Thanks so much for watching, guys. We had so much fun with him.
Bye.
I had fun being here.
Bye.
Our founder, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and me, Maria Menounos, would like to thank you for tuning in to AfterBuzz TV. Remember, we're not just the first, we're the biggest in the world, and we're the only destination for all your favorite TV shows. Whatever you crave, we've got it. So go to AfterBuzzTV.com and check out our lineup. Buzz you later.
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.